for 23 years with her curlers. Muriel.
Sandy did it all himself, you know. Well, the Muriel, anyway.
Unique way with words.
Eggs and aspic, you know, for the Allstoopers. Oh, get away.
Forthright opinions.
Right. I've got a few things to say to certain people in here.
Ah, they didn't believe
Hilda Ogden was a much-loved part of daily life for minutes.
Drawn here compulsory, was she? By me singing. You know, the way them singing sirens used to draw unsuspecting sailors to their doom.
Jean Alexander first appeared as Hilda in 1964. She was a jobbing actress and thought it might mean a few weeks' work.
Well, feeling a bit of enough for me, love.
Well, in that case, a double scotch.
The name Hilda Ogden. That's our Frida.
But it wasn't long before she and the producers began to see potential in Stan and Hilda.
The character was originally written as a rather stereotyped character, as Stan was, you know, a big fat man and lazy husband and little nagging wife.
I bet Barbara Carpenter never has all this trouble.
Well, after a few weeks, we thought this was going to get a bit boring, so we started playing against the script. Same words, but trying to give them a bit more character, you know, rounding it out a bit.
Jean Alexander had begun working life as a librarian. She'd grown up in Toxteth and Liverpool, and, like Hilda, believed in self-improvement, but that was as far as any similarity went. Hard-working, self-contained, she spent 11 years in rep and occasional TV roles.
Oh, what did I tell you? We could never afford that.
But you can, you know. Excuse me butting in.
The Undressing of Cats, RTS.
By the late 80s, she was more than glad to leave Hilda behind.
I'm tired, Julia, because I stayed up till 1:30 last night watching the snooker.
There was the sitcom Rich Tea and Sympathy, Last of the Summer Wine.
Norman Jenks a chicken!
But nothing could rival Hilda.
Anna Yen!
Strident, funny, but played with a warmth that made her one of the nation's best-loved TV characters.